Okay, so here's what you can ask me. I'm gonna
then you're a question. And then you're going to answer a good question.
With large language models, a common problem is around hallucinations. So these models tend to make up fact as if it's true. So you're telling me
it's a statistical model, so they are going to reply regardless if they know. Because at the end of the day, they always provide an answer. Could be completely misleading.
Yeah, because this is statistical probabilities using Bayesian probability. So it will go and say that there's a restaurant right next door here, and you're sitting, you're like, I don't see a restaurant right there. But they were like, nope, there's a restaurant literally 500 feet
from here. If you ask her to suggest you like a new song of an artist that you know, it might produce a completely reasonably title, even if it doesn't exist at all.
Yeah, so. Even if you tell it to make up the lyrics, it will make up the lyrics for you. Because it just knows, based on the questions, the type of genre, it will go produce content. It's going to go answer. So now the next question comes, how do you resolve that? How do you work around this problem with hallucination?
Yeah, how you sort of try to prevent or limit this kind of challenges. And overall, there are different techniques that are still in evolution. It's everything in this field is still evolving. But one of the most, let's say, appealing is to try to force the model to stay within a context so that produce the answer only considering a specific set of knowledge that you are going to provide. So this is a very common, for example, use case. If you're thinking about a scenario where you have a big knowledge base of all your documentation and you want to find a very effective way to produce the result. You wanted to force the model to stay within that content. You maybe already also have a way to select a subset of them to say like, okay, this is all the material that I know about a specific field. Stay within that boundaries and give me the result. Try to answer this question.
So let's take it a step further with an example. Let's say you want to say, find me top 10 restaurants in Raleigh, North Carolina that are open tonight. And then you give it a list of, but here's 100 restaurants that I want you to pick and give me the top 10 from these 100 restaurants. So then the model knows that I cannot go and just do a Google search or go to Yelp.com and find all the possible combination, but I have been given a boundary, like this is my context and I need to find, based on the requirements, the questions that are asked, the answers needs to come from this list. So it goes back and looks at the original model, gets an answer back, then looks back like, do they fit within this 100 restaurants list? If they do, then I'm going to go and give that answer back.